Hello, everybody. I'm Doug Limerick, and this is Limerick on Life.
The year of the cat.
No, not the cat. It's the year of the rat. Yes, the Chinese Lunar New Year begins this weekend, and it marks the beginning of the year of the rat. According to the Chinese zodiac, those born in the year of the rat are clever, quick thinkers. There are songs about rats, such as...
Been the two of us needless no more.
No doubt about it, Ben was a leader of rodents. There have been movies about rats.
And finally, the pièce de résistance, a very special, very rare...
Disney's Ratatouille. Some people have even gotten their names from rats, like Ratso Rizzo.
Hey, I'm walking here! I'm walking here!
That, of course, from Midnight Cowboy. And who can forget Sinatra, Martin, Davis, and other members of Hollywood's Rat Pack? But for many of us, rats are not pleasant animals. In fact, they're downright disgusting.
Come out and take it, you dirty yellow-bellied rat, or I'll give it to you through the door.
And according to Orkin, the pest control company, the U.S. city with the most rats is Chicago.
R-A-T-T. Rat.
Followed by L.A., New York, and Washington, D.C. In fact, there are even rats in the White House. The old days when I walked to work in downtown D.C. at 3 o'clock in the morning, I would often see the little critters scampering down the street. Little devils. Some humans, of course, deathly afraid of rats, like the guy in the movie 1984.
In your case, it is rats.
Big Brother knew his greatest fear. But no matter how you feel about rats, more than a billion Chinese will be celebrating the arrival of 2020, the year of the rat, this weekend. No, it's the year of the rat, not the cat.
新年快乐.
It's Happy New Year in Mandarin.
新年快乐.
That's A Slice of Life. I'm Doug Limerick. Sure hope you enjoyed the podcast. You'll find a complete podcast library on my website, my new website, DougLimerick.com. Check it out. Let us know what you think.